go ahead and introduce yourself?
Yeah, hi, I'm Isabel Marcus. I'm almost 18 years old. I'm from Texas, and I'm on This Is Us.
Okay, terrific. So so I understand that you were in the first episode, which was...
Of this season, yeah.
Of this season, which is one of the most talk about episodes. So why don't you go ahead and kind of like re-elaborate on what actually happened?
Yeah, so this show was big basically from the beginning, and we ended the first season sort of some family turmoil. There's been fight between Jack and Rebecca, the parents, and a lot is going on. And so in the first episode, that's where we start, and some of that gets resolved. There's some back and forth, and we get to see, you know, some of it wind up and some of it continue. But really what the biggest moment of that episode was is that we get another clue into how Jack, the dad, died. And at the end, so first you see Jack and Rebecca having a really important moment about his alcoholism. And then there's a scene where I'm holding Randall's hand, the son, and they've just been told that their father has passed away, and the son, Randall, and daughter, Kate, say that they need to find their sibling, Kevin. And then the last shot of the episode, this is what everyone is always talking about, is Rebecca drives up to a house, and she's got Jack's things in the back seat, and she breaks down, and it pans up, and we see that there is a house behind her that has clearly burned down. And we can sort of assume or tell that it's the Pearson's house, and that's the episode, and that's what everyone's still talking about. It's still, what does the fire mean?
You know, I remember that episode, and I didn't think they resolved it during the first half of the season, but are they going to resolve it in the rest of the half of the second season here?
They sure are, and one thing that I've really respected about everyone on the show, but specifically Dan Fogelman, said, you know, we're not going to try to, like, draw this out and make it, like, a murder mystery thing. Not that it was murder, but a mystery idea. We're not going to try to draw it out. They're going to wrap it up this season, and they're going to let you know. Because it's about the family, and it's about the stories of each family member, and not about this, like, one giant thing that happened in their life. So, yes, we'll get closure this season.
Now, let's talk about your character here. You had a brief moment during the first half of the season of the second season, but do you have a much more expanded role in the second half?
I would like to think so. Yeah, I've shot a little bit more since then. I am coming back next week, January 16th, and then I'll be around for a couple more weeks after that. So, yeah, my character gets to sort of stick around a little bit and be part of the Pearson's life.
Now, how proud of for you to be on a show this big of This Is Us?
So proud. Insane. Absolutely crazy. It's a whirlwind. It's my first television job. I've done student films and short films and music videos, and those have all been great, but this is my first television gig, and pun unintended. And to have my first television role be not only on NBC, which is one of the biggest, I mean, it's been around since the beginning. It is an incredibly good studio. But to also have it be on such an incredible show watched by so many people that's just really well made, and everyone on it is like very professional and good at what they do, and also nice. They're just nice people. And for it to be a recurring role, it's not just a one-off thing. It's a thing where I get to allow my character to grow and develop for America and for the eyes of many. So it's an incredible feeling. It's an incredible experience. And I guess I couldn't have wished for anything better.
How did you originally score the part? I mean, how did they actually, like, did you audition? Did they just approach you, or?
Yeah, I'm not offer only yet. So, I had been in Los Angeles for a year, living in Los Angeles for a year. And I've been coming back and forth to Los Angeles for many years and auditioning here, sending in taped auditions there. I'm from Texas, and I had an agent in Texas and an agent in Los Angeles. And so I've been auditioning around playing the circuits for several years. And then I moved to Los Angeles in 2016. And so I had been here for almost a year, and I went back to Texas to visit family, and I was hanging out with my dad and my stepmom and my baby brother, and then one night, a Wednesday night, I got a call, and it was my manager said, "Hey, you have an audition." And I was like, "I don't think so. I'm half a country away." And there was all this secrecy around it, because there was all this, they said no one outside of the casting room, no one who won't be in the casting room should see the side, should see this material. It's only for people who will be in the casting room acting or whatever. And so it did not, I think even the audition request might have even said, like, no taped auditions allowed. But we asked, and we asked if I could send in a taped audition, and they said yes, which was just the most amazing thing, because it could have ended there. They could have said no, and that would have been the end of the story, and someone else would have gotten the role, and that would have been fine, because they would have done great, but magically, miraculously, they let me send in a taped audition. So on Thursday, I shot a taped audition with a coach I've worked with several times before, Lar Park Lincoln. She's from the Friday the 13th movies, and she's done a lot. And she really helped me perfect that tape. And so Thursday, we sent in the tape. Friday, they pinned me for the role. Saturday, I flew out. Sunday, I went to an acting class with my manager. Monday, I had a chemistry read. Tuesday, I got the role. And Wednesday, I was on the Paramount lot. So in less than a week, I had auditioned for the role and booked it. And so it was this crazy whirlwind thing. And it seems like it's sort of a discovered in the mall or the grocery store sort of story, but it's not. It's been, you know, 6 years in the making, and friends and family and my mom and my coaches and my teachers and my agents and managers and everyone sort of helping me get here. So, crazy.
Well, that sounds like a dream come true. How's a life adjustment here and, you know, in Los Angeles for you?
Well, I'm really thankful that I had that year to get used to Los Angeles, because this is a crazy city. I'm from San Antonio, Texas, which is a great city, but it's slow, you know? It's sort of like, yeah, we're going to go out for tacos at 11 o'clock in the morning. And I love that vibe, but Los Angeles is very different. Ultimately not so different that it was overwhelming, and I really like it here. Luckily, I had gotten the opportunity to be here and get used to it, and so when I got the role, I didn't have to figure out when to walk the dog around when to go to the Paramount lot, and the Paramount lot is 15 minutes from my house, which is great. So it really all just clicked, and it made sense, but yeah, you know, LA isn't as scary as everyone says. It's really not. It's a great place, and you find your friends, and you find your community, and you find where you're supposed to be. And there is that diversity. Everyone can find somewhere they're meant to be, and I think it's a great city.
So tell me about your first experience stepping onto that Paramount lot for This Is Us. I mean, what was that like?
Well, my mom was still in Texas, so my manager drove me. But, you know, he had work to do, and so, like, he couldn't be holding my hand through the process. He was like, "I'm gonna drive you, and then you're on your own," which is totally fine, and it ended up being great, but it was scary. You know, I had to, like, fill out my own paperwork, and I was like, what if I sign my signature wrong? And, you know, the Paramount lot is huge, and you drive through these gates that have been in movies and television for your entire life, and you drive up and the security guard asks for your ID, and then you're afraid that he won't let you in for some ridiculous reason, and so it's this overwhelming sense of emotion, and the buildings are big and the people are big, and it's sort of all of the Hollywood thing that you could imagine. And there were posters, you know, I remember seeing banners for This Is Us on the sides of the sound stages, and they're like 10 feet tall, and I'm like looking up at it like, oh, it was an incredible experience. And in a lot of ways overwhelming, but it was like this strange mix of like surreal and bizarre, and also I felt right at home. You know, I felt like, yeah, this is what I'm meant to be doing. This is where I'm meant to be. So it was a great, incredible, terrifying mix of experiences.
Tell me about the rest of the cast. I mean, it must be so cool to meet everybody on such a popular TV show.
Insane. It was incredible. I had the chemistry read with Niles Fitch, which already was really exciting, you know. To get to meet him and work with him, he's so talented. It was like, wow, just to be in the same room with you and all this talent and craft is incredible. And then on my first day, I met Mandy Moore in the makeup trailer and Chris Sullivan, who plays Toby. And he was like, hey, how's it going? And I was like, good. And he's like, you part of the This Is Us family now? And I was like, I guess so, yes. And then I came out of the makeup trailer and there was Sterling K. Brown and Susan Kelechi Watson, who are just two of the most incredible actors and prettiest people on the planet. And they're like driving away in the golf cart and they said hi to me and they were like, oh, you're my girlfriend in the past. And I was like, yeah, that's me. It was a crazy whirlwind of experiences, but and not just the cast, but the crew also. They're so good at what they do. I mean, really on top of it and really professional, but also like they don't hesitate to crack a joke. There's no like anger or sternness about it. It's just they're there to work, and it's a beautiful feeling to be surrounded by that. And the directors are always really good. They're just good directors, and they're all good people. And I'll tell you what, everyone on that show is prettier in person than they are on screen. Like, I don't know how they do it, but People Magazine said, oh, sexiest cast. It's true. In person, they're the most beautiful people. And it like takes my breath away. And also I'm like, am I on the right show? Like, am I that pretty? You know, it's this weird, it's incredible.
So does it seem like a family type of atmosphere on set? Did you get a chance to hang out with anybody specifically?
Yeah, I've gotten to, obviously, I've hung out with Niles Fitch a lot because we're in the same scenes, because otherwise Randall's girlfriend wouldn't make sense. But you also got to see that I was hanging out with Hannah Zeal for the first episode. I was in the scene with her, and at this point I've gotten to meet everybody on the, except Chrissy Metzger and Justin Hartley. I haven't met them yet, and I'm really pulling for that. But I got to meet the whole Pearson family, whether in the makeup trailer or on set or passing by. So I've met Milo and Mandy and everybody. And it does feel like a family. And again, not just the cast, but the crew as well. They're all very close, you know. I think that it's just incredible the amount of connectedness that everyone feels and how kind everyone is and welcoming. I mean, right away I was enfolded in the Pearson family, and so was my character. So
what about working with Dan Fogelman? I mean, he is such a big producer in the television world.
I haven't gotten to meet Dan Fogelman
yet. No way.
He was on set when I was on set, like literally almost, I guess, a week ago, maybe a little bit more than that. Apparently he was on set, and he was sitting there and he had his own chair and I saw his chair and I didn't get to meet him. And I'm so, because he's so talented and he's such a genius. and this is his brainchild, and I really want to meet him. I just want to say thank you. Ultimately, I just want to shake his hand and be like, thank you for giving the world this piece of art. So hopefully someday.
Can you tell us maybe a surprising fact about This Is Us that a lot of people don't know about? Maybe that that you walk on the set and you discover it and, well, I didn't know about this. Without, you know, spoilers or anything like that.
I can't think of anything. I think that part of what makes this show so incredible is that it's such an open book. You know, the actors and the show, there's no drama except the drama on the show. There's no drama between people. There's no secrets except the secrecy that is very specific to make the show better for you. I will say I was stunned when they had to make Mandy Moore look older even in the past. Like, she's so beautiful and her skin is so perfect that they have to add wrinkles even when she's playing just slightly older than her age, because she doesn't look her, you know, she looks so perfect that they have to make her unperfect, and that was hilarious to me. But no, it's an open book, and it's beautiful that way.
Well, let's talk a little bit more about yourself. Did you always want to be an actress for yourself? How did you get your start?
I had been performing in things for a really long time. I did dance recitals when I was younger, and I used to play with sticks in my backyard and then like make my family watch me make up stories. I remember at one point I got this guitar like purse, like, but it was like full-sized guitar, and I was like, I went to my grandma and grandpa's house with my dad, and I rocked out in the kitchen, and I was like, nah, 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 and then I like slammed it on the ground because I thought I was so cool. And it's just always been part of me to be like, performance. And then in fifth grade, I got the opportunity to be the Queen of Hearts in Alice in Wonderland at my school. We got a theater program, which is now one of the best public school theater programs in the city, in San Antonio. Bonham Academy, really solid, and I got to be sort of a pioneer for that, which was incredible. And then I was in James and the Giant Peach there, and I just loved it. I loved the feeling of being on stage, and I've always thought that I've always been told I could do anything, which is an important lesson for everybody, because you can. And then when it came down to it, I was like, yeah, I guess I could do anything, but I don't want to do anything except this. I just loved it. And so my mom facilitated that. She was like, you want to do this? This is what you want to do with your life? Let's make it happen. And I was like, okay, let's make it happen. It became clear after stepping out onto a stage and feeling the power and the control that that gave me, that this is what I needed to do.
Now, I know you're starting your young career here. What kind of roles do you covet the most that you would love to play?
I love playing the bad guys. You know, I did the Queen of Hearts, and she was incredible, and also the bad guy. And I played the evil fairy in an adaptation of, I think it was Sleeping Beauty. And I got to walk down the aisle between the audience halves to Darth Vader's march. And that was like incredible. You know, I'm in this long black dress, dun, dun, dun. And so I like playing the bad guys. But I also, recently I'm really loving the kind of girlfriend character, the girl next door, but not just stereotypical, you know, like, love interest, but a girl next door with some body to her, with a lot of character and a lot of personality. And Disney just announced that they're doing a live-action Little Mermaid. Well, not just announced. They have announced that they're doing a live-action Little Mermaid. And I feel like I could pull off Ariel. I mean, step one, hair. And I did that. So, and I went to a performing arts school in San Antonio. And I can sing. So, that's really what I'm going for. So, Ariel.
I do have to admire, you do have very nice signature red hair. You think this is an advantage in this business?
Thank you. Yes, absolutely. It makes you slightly harder to cast in some places because, you know, like you can't match family as easily. But, you know, when I auditioned for the role for This Is Us, it was called Redheaded Teen Girl. And that's how I was labeled on the episode, was Redheaded Teen Girl. And I was like, I can do that. That's me. I know how to do that. It's definitely an advantage. It makes you stand out. It makes you more castable for certain things. It's definitely an advantage, but it's not the only thing. Looks are a lot of it, but it's about talent and persistence and longevity and care in the craft.
Do you have any Hollywood actresses that's a role model to you that you would love to emulate?
I think Emma Stone is an incredible soul. She's an incredible actor. She's just talented and good all around. I get compared to Ellen Page a lot, which I don't know where that comes from, but thank you. She's incredible too. I can't help mentioning Meryl Streep. Everyone says Meryl Streep, but rightly so. I love that she was able to, she's so poised in everything she does. She found a way to get out of Hollywood, but stay in Hollywood. And that means that she's able to do it for the work. When I was really young, Anne Hathaway was my favorite actress, and I think that still holds. There's still a part of me that is like, wow, she's incredible. I watched Ella Enchanted the movie like over and over and over again, mostly for her. I think that's my list, but really anyone who's out here trying to do this is respect.
Now, you are 17, you're going to be 18 pretty soon, but one of the biggest struggles for like a lot of young actors is trying to balance their life. How are you going to manage to do that?
I'm graduating high school soon, and my plan is to take a gap year before college. I'm going to college, but I'm going to take a gap year and sort of learn what it looks like to be an adult in Los Angeles and an actor in Los Angeles before I also learn how to be a student in Los Angeles. But I was really fortunate to have a mom who came out here with me to get to know the city before I had to strike out on my own. And so by the time she leaves, I'll have had 2 years of getting used to this place. And I think it's about balance mentally. I think, you know, you have to take care of your body and your mind for being an actor, but also for being a human. So I think in a lot of ways they go hand in hand. Just practicing goodness and balance in everything you do makes you a good, balanced actor.
Terrific. Well, let me start wrapping things up. Is This Is Us the only project that you have in the pipeline for yourself?
I mean, high school is a project. My dog is a project. No, right now I don't have anything right on the table, but it is pilot season. We're going into pilot season, and This Is Us. My episodes are gonna start running next week. And so hopefully things will be coming my way more, and I'm really open to whatever shoots my way. I would love to do more television. I would love to do movies. And sort of anything. I'm down for anything.
Terrific. And just real fast, give us a quick teaser for the rest of the season of season 2 for This Is Us.
Get ready to cry. grab your tissues, man. It's gonna be a whirlwind.
All right. Hey, thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Appreciate for this interview. Terrific. Thank you.